Hi, this is Scott Haskins, Art Conservator. And I think I mentioned in the exhibition video that I made that they were from Venice. And I'm in Venice now, and that right there is the house of Tintoretto, where he lived for over 20 years. These are the walkways, these are the canals where he lived back in the 1500s. Wow, what a great visit. And I'm gonna show you a couple things that make this neighborhood special and that are something that you would never know about, that you can't see, and that are a very cool insight into the world of conservation. So it's known that Tintoretto moved into this neighborhood, into the house of his father, after he had already been successful and started getting large painting commissions. Of course, big commissions brought in some good money, and so the house shows signs of this affluency. The Turkish art and the Byzantine style was very popular back then. In many ways, the neighborhood hasn't changed in 500 years. The Tintoretto's parish church around the corner was already 150 years old when Tintoretto was born. Today it remains one of the most unadulterated, unchanged Gothic churches in Venice. As you might guess, it's filled with the Tintoretto family's artwork, and in fact, they have a place of honor, and many of the Tintoretto family are buried here. Let's take a look at some of the work in Venice that made Tintoretto famous. The Scuola Grande San Rocco was a home-run commission in his lifetime. This is an exceptional example of influence, power, and riches, and Baroque art on steroids. Not only was Tintoretto a great artist, he had a mind for marketing. When the organization began asking for submissions to choose an artist to decorate this place, Tintoretto showed up with a complete full-sized painting and gave it to them for free. That meant they had to choose him if they wanted all the paintings to look the same. This obviously did not go over well with the other artists in the city. This is the outside of the art restoration, art conservation facility used by the Italian government. And this whole building is being used for the conservation and restoration of the large paintings that they have here in Venice. I came by the lab at the invitation of some professional associates of mine. There is always world-class art to see, and since we work on big projects, we love to compare notes and talk shop. In this painting conservation lab, the paintings are always so large that they have to use scaffolding. Given that these paintings have been through numerous infestations, fires, or wars, you can imagine the problems that need to be resolved. These big paintings are always surrounded by molding or frames to hold them to the walls or to the ceilings. And so you can see that once they get the molding apart, then they can work on the paintings. Special considerations and extra care are always given when handling big paintings. In fact, here we are using a 4-foot diameter tube for handling a mural in the Central Library of Los Angeles. So that's what these tubes are for here in the corner of the lab. Both this important lab and the major production studio next door are completely incognito and unknown by passerbys. Turns out Tintoretto's neighborhood is full of interesting things and surprises.